हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू टेस्का टेक्नोलॉजीज प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। माय नेम इज़ ललिता एंड टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट EPABX सिस्टम एंड इट्स ऑर्डर कोड इज़ 10946। बेसिकली EPABX इज़ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक प्राइवेट ऑटोमेटिक ब्रांच एक्सचेंजर। इट इज़ एन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइस विच इज़ यूज इन ऑफिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस एंड इंडस्ट्रीज फॉर वॉइस कम्युनिकेशन। Now I am going to giving you an overview of this EPABX trainer. In this EPABX is different blocks. This is the power supply block and this one is tone generator block. This is DTMF section. This is matrix block. This is CPU and logic block. This is trunk 20. This is trunk 21, this is extension 30, this is extension 31, this is extension 32, and this is extension 33. Through the extensions, CN3, CN4, CN5, and CN6 are connected, and this is the clock and ringer. Let's start the experiment one by one. In EPABX, we have total 5 experiments. The first experiment is to study fundamentals of EPABX and telephone set. As I told you, the EPABX is electronic private automatic branch exchanger. It is an electronic device which is independent and it can be used without help of any service provider. EPABX has different features such as transferring of calls, call pickup, call backup and conference. EPABX is an essential equipment which is made communication easier for different organizations and office. And if you want to know more about this experiment, you can go through the lab manuals for getting the deep knowledge about this experiment. Now we will learn about the telephone set. This is the telephone set and we will connect this telephone set to the EPABX. In this telephone set, we have a keypad box. Telephone keypad is laid out in 4x4 matrix of push button, in which each row represents the low frequency component and each column represents the high frequency component of the DTMF signal. Pressing a key sends a combination of the row and column frequencies. For example, the key will produce the superimpositions of tones of 697 and 1209 hertz. In this keypad system, we have different type of button. There we have the button of mute. As long as key is kept pressed, the other party will not be able to hear you. There is second button, which is push button. And if I press this button, a delay between the digit for dialing with EPABX or to access a long distance service occur. This is the flash button. The flash key is used to access the facility offered by some EPABX or network service provider. This is the redial button. To redial the last number dialed. And this is the ring indicator. The ring indicator shows the incoming calls, hand sent, service volume setting. The receiver volume can be adjusted by using the side switch mounted on rear side of base unit. Now we will start the second experiment, which is to study the fundamental of DTMF. Basically, DTMF is dual tone multi-frequency singling. DTMF is used to generate the sounds and tones when we press any key on the telephone set. Basically, the use of DTMF is used to identify the dialed numbers, and DTMF is applicable in house automations, call centers, security centers, and it is also usable in industries applications. We will know more about this DTMF by practical experiment. Now, with the help of DSO, we will see the changes in frequency when I connect it to the ground and the DTMF. And I will call from extension 33 to 30. You can see the result here. Frequency changes from upper to lower. Now we will start the third number experiment to understand the working of hardware detail of the EPABX trainer. The EPABX trainer consists of the following block. The first block is trunk block. Trainer has on board two trunks, trunk 20 and trunk 21, which has two connectors CN1 and CN2 respectively. Through those two connectors, trunk 20 and trunk 21 can be connected. Then we have the extension block. In this extension block, we have four extensions: extension 30, extension 31, extension 32, extension 33, and its corresponding connectors are CN3, CN4, CN5 and CN6 are connected. Through those four connectors, telephone can be connected. Then we have clock and ringer block. Trainer has onboard clock and ringer block. And then we have the DTMF section. DTMF block has two frequency group, lower and higher frequency group. Then we have the tone generator block. Tone generator block is used to give the tone or music to the caller when call forwarding is in process. Then we have the power supply block. Power supply block consists of different power supply: 5 volt, plus 24 volt, plus 15 volt and ground. This is used to give the supply to the CPU and different parts of the trainer. And next we have the CPU and logic block. The main body is adapted 89E516RD CPU that is integrated with RAM, ROM, HK, SW, read, ring, write, LED, write and matrix select. It use RAM and ROM inside the chip. Then we have the matrix block. This block is integrated with extension 30, extension 31, extension 32, extension 33, music, DTMF, TRM, TR1, TR2 and link 1. Now we will start the experiment number 4 to understand the working of EPABX trainer. We will start the experiment step by step. First of all, we will connect the trainer kit to the AC supply. Then we will connect trunk line to any one of connector CN1 or CN2 of trunk 20 of or trunk 21. So let's connect the extensions one by one. In next step, we will connect four telephone set to all the four connectors CN3, CN4, CN5 and CN6 of extensions 30, 31, 32, 33. Like that, you will connect all the telephone set to the extensions. We have connected to all telephone set to the extensions. Now we will do the practical. I will call from extension 33 to 30. You can see we have the results here. If I want to call from extension 31 to 33, the ring is playing. I also can do call from 32 to 33. If I want to do call from 30 to 32, you can see results from one extension to another extension. We can call like that. Now we will start the experiment number 5th to study the fault switch and its effect on EPABX trainer. We will make the connections of experiment number 5th same as experiment number 4. Now this is the fault switch block where we have different types of switches. The first switch is FS1, FS2, FS3, FS4, FS5, FS6, FS7, FS8. If I off the FS1 button, music tone will be disabled, hence caller cannot hear music tone while call is being transferred. If I off the button FS3, keypad tone of TR1 disabled, hence user cannot dial any number. We can see it by practically. Let's off the button FS3. Now if I call from 33 extension to 31, you can see we didn't get any output. Extension 31 is not giving any ringing, and open it again. If I close off the button FS4, ETN exchange tone will be disabled, and if I off the button FS5, hook slot of extension 31 is disconnected, and if I off the button FS6, FX6, extension 31 ringle single disabled. I have off the button FX6. Now I will be call from 32 to 31. See, there is no response from extension 31. So we can say that after off the button of FS6, extension 31 ringer single is disabled. I open it again. FS7, if I off the button FS7, trunk 20 ringer single will be disabled. And last one, if I FS8 is off, CO1 trunk 20 disabled, hence user cannot access the trunk 20. So through this experiment we can say that fault switch is played a biggest role in EPBX trainer. So it's all the demonstration which is given by me. If you have any query related to this apparatus, you can go through the link which is given in the description. And if you want to get more information about this device and experiments, you can go through the lab manuals. And thanks for watching this video. If you like it, like, share and subscribe our channel.